What is best in life? To crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and to hear the lamentation of your women.
I'm gonna actually start the recording up here. We'll do a quick look at the,
Should we, move to the Blood Bowl channel, or do we care?
It's fine. Alright, so who's at home? You're at home. That's right, you have, crowd surf, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Alright, you got a 14-man roster. The two wolves are what's gonna scare me the most. A couple of nice flesh golems, though. Block garters. A couple of dodging whites. One with diving tackle, one with guard. Block guard zombie, strength 4 zombie, rookie zombie, guard zombie, wrestle zombie, dirty player zombie, rookie zombie, and block guard core. Sure hands, block guard.
I'm predicting either way the ghoul doesn't survive the match.
Well, you never know. 10 fan factor, 3 rerolls. Sitting at 2060 currently. If he keeps his money. I'm sitting at 190. If I keep my money. 13 fan factor as well. I've got all 12 of my guys going this game. I contemplated getting rid of the edge boosted skeleton.
Oh, I think I'm ready.
Because of the move break and the bloat.
Dude, I still don't understand how you can run a 12-man Camry team.
Even at move 4, the edge 3 is still worth it, I think. In a pinch. That is a lot of bloat to carry, though, for a move 4 piece. But he does still have block tackle, which makes him nice, too, so... Alright, well, invite is sent. And he puts money in to buy an Igor. So, do I really want to go for the win? Put 30k in for the wizard? Or do I go the safe and smart route and get the Igor like he did? We're gonna go the safe route and go with the Igor. Put 30k in for the babe.
Yeah, I figured since I had the money, the Igor was probably the way to go.
Yep.
I really didn't know what you were gonna do. I thought you might go bribe and,
Nah.
Babe.
I don't need to go bribe. If I don't go Igor, I go with the wizard. But I'm not that gung-ho on trying to win. I mean, I want to win, but I'd rather have team preservation possibilities than the wizard to try to win.
Yeah, I'm not overly concerned with winning in this one, to be honest.
Yep, that's right, body armor. That is why they do not have regen. Well, that's not good.
What's not good?
That you won the kickoff. I did get fame, though, so that's nice. Problem is... So, you might take care of the, hold on. Do what? Fuck. Hold on. I can probably do it. Can we pause for 15 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, I need to run up to the store real quick.
Yeah, no, that's no worries.
All right, I'll finish setting up here and then I'll pause it.
Can't hear what she's saying, but she sounds distressed.
She is. Well, we're leaving in the morning to drive to Dallas, and she's trying to get everything done at once. Things are backfiring on her. So, all right, I'll be back here in a few minutes.
Okay.
I'll be right back, Strength.
Good game. Just trying to find a trade in one of my leagues.
25.
All right, I'm in.
All right, swerve jump off, I take it?
Yeah, his wife texted him and asked and wanted him to come watch a show with her, so.
I gotcha. All right, here we go. Thanks for waiting.
Yeah, no worries.
All right, let me just double check here. 1, 2, 3. Bam. Get her off. All right.
Thanks for rescheduling from last night, so I wasn't in the mood to play.
Oh, I can imagine, dude.
I was just kind of wiped, didn't really want to concentrate hard on anything.
Right. Makes perfect sense. You see, I beat Durden this week, gave him his first loss.
I didn't, but sweet.
In the Empire League, yep. Gave him his first loss, slowed him down a little bit. Now we just got to slow down the heaving beasts. That's one of your
yeah, Lisa, right? She's never really done super well in fantasy football, so that's kind of surprising.
She's got a good team. She shouldn't have beat me last week. She just had
she shouldn't have beat me in week one either, but
yeah, she just had
Doug Baldwin got hurt and I lost by like 2.8 points.
Yeah, I didn't
with a zero.
Much. Two leagues this week. A family league and a money league. And my money league, I had Antonio Brown, and I was down by 15 points. He got 14 points in the first half, got shut out in the second half. All I needed was one catch and three for 3 yards, and I get enough points to get ahead of it. And he gets fucking shut out in the second half. Really?
Yeah, then, that was pretty crazy.
Then, in my family league, I have Schuster, and I'm down by 19. So I need 19 to tie and 20 to win. And he gets 15. So I end up losing by 4. But when they were driving at the end of the first half, and he had that 12-yard catch and got pushed out of bounds on the 2-yard line, if he doesn't get pushed out of bounds and he scores there, then I get enough points to get ahead of him and win. So both leagues, I was just that close to be getting ahead and winning in both of them, and I just missed. Talk about frustrating. And the league where I had Schuster, where I needed 19. I had Matt Ryan. And I scored 143. Yeah, I scored 143 total. My opponent had Drew Brees and scored 148. Second most points in the league I scored. Anybody else I play and I smash them. Go figure, right? Ooh, that's nice. Come on, one more dodge. One more, baby, one more. Oh! Hey, I'll take it.
I bet you will.
I will take that all day long. Yes, yes, yes. Whew. Well, I dodged
saves
one
you
hit.
A foul, too. That was yep. A pretty big dodge there.
Yes, sir, it is. Yes, it is.
So you're back down to no block Tomb Guardians again, huh?
Oh, I've been that way for a while.
Yeah, every time you get one, it gets killed.
Yep, I'm at 14 right now on my streak of block Tomb Guardians dying and failing regen. 14 in a row that have died have failed regen. Not, they haven't all been block, but 14 Tomb Guardians. Just Tomb Guardians in general, in a row. The last 14 that have died have all failed. Go figure, right?
Yep.
Not sure if I want to. Not really sure if I want to do that or not. Not really for sure. To be completely honest. Do what? Cool. I think I'm gonna get a little risky here. I was going to get risky and go after your wolf, but I forgot that guy has frenzy.
And I have sidestep.
I know.
Could have ended up poorly.
I know.
Could have ended up poorly.
I know. That's why I modified my plan of action. That is why I modified my plan of action.
Say, you're giving me some chances here.
I am. I told you I was gonna play a little risky. That's why I decided to go ahead and keep him, even though I knew I had to put him on the line. He can at least get up and dodge away. Got a fairly decent chance, right? Now, what do I do with him? Sleeping right there. Yeah, I put some stuff out there for you. See how risky and greedy you want to get.
Man.
Chance to take both 30 players out with one hit.
Okay, I guess. Block dice leave a lot to be desired right now.
And you didn't break either one of them. What the hell?
I was debating whether to dodge away first or do the block, but I was like, eh, it's good dice. It should be relatively safe. Same odds as the dodge.
Thank you. Stupid. I shouldn't have pushed him. I should not have pushed him. Yeah, let's do it. At least make you make a dodge. That's why I shouldn't have pushed. I should have just stayed there. You wouldn't have had two dice on him. Bad decision on my part. I knew I was going to give that to you.
The smart move is to dodge, but I also want to kill him.
Okay. Let's see here. How do I want to do this?
Wow. 661666.
Just made your region. Because that was going to be a bad Miss Next game.
Eh, Miss Next game's fine. Same old shit, different game. Seriously, I'm stealing your goddamn cash dice or armor dice for a game sometime.
As long as it's not when you're playing against me, I'm okay.
I was shocked I actually got a removal against you.
Tempted to reroll that. Was so tempted to. I'm glad I did. Absolutely glad that I did. That was why I didn't, because I knew I still had that one die to hit. And I needed to get a yellow or a push. I didn't really want them both down there, because I wanted to push him out of there. I wanted him off my edge piece.
Hey, broke armor, that's a step up.
It is. That it is.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you're worried about the wolves, they've done dick all so far.
No, but every time they hit a Tomb Guardian, I grimace. you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. I know what you mean. I'm just saying, like, they're not doing a damn thing to you yet.
Not yet. Game's a long ways from over, though. Fuck, how do I want to do this? Other way now.
Dodge is not doing him any good, but at least his armor's holding.
I wish I would have freaking went a different way with him now. Because then I would have done that. But now I can't.
Yeah, pounded the shit out of him, eventually got through.
His armor 8's been holding up pretty good so far.
Hey, Wolf did something.
And he sticks. Well, that'll suck if I do win this game. No, I only have 11 against McLean. What's up, Trumpet? Getting super risky, huh?
Yeah, 2-2 pluses. Look out. Uh-oh. Wolves are kicking off now. Ready to kill yourself, Stubby? Oh man, surprised you re-rolled that, especially when you had a 3-dive with Tomb Guardian coming.
I had to. Because I needed to move these pieces with my guard around. I wasn't planning on piling on. I needed to get this guard down here. Gotta make you make dice rolls. Don't do anything at least. Try to force you into a spot where you might double fail. Yeah, of course you roll six.
Well, that's a 2+.
I know, but still. Even just one to make you use a dodge would have been nice. At least you didn't break. That's good.
Oh, I knew I wasn't gonna break. I know your blitz rods are literally bulletproof.
Yeah, sometimes. The one you just KO'd has died a few times already. Khafra. The reborn iteration of Khafra has not been good. He keeps dying on me. But the one you just hit, he's been the new Khafra. He's bulletproof. If he can get a strength bump on his last skill up, then he'll definitely be Khafra reborn.
Yeah, there's no reason for me to stall here. Just taking a lot of hits I don't want to take.
I was wondering if that's what you were going to try to do or not.
No.
Nice one. I thought you might maybe try it one more time.
I typically try to score fast with this team and play defense. Like I do. I kind of run them up similar to my lizards in that way.
All in all, that half hurt, or that drive hurt me more than hurt you.
Because of the... Yeah, well, I have a bench.
Well, and you made both two of your three KOs.
Who was KO'd?
I did need a babe.
Was anybody I cared about?
I did need my babe. Well, your dirty player stayed out.
Yeah, I think they were all zombies, so it wasn't a huge deal.
Well, but still, players, right?
I have 14-man roster. I can handle 3 losses.
I know, but it's still the players, right? If you don't get them back on this one or the next one, and I start taking more people off, then you're under 11. But now it doesn't matter. If I take 2 or 3 off now, you're still going to be at 11, even if you fail your KOs. But 2 out of 3, that's could have went either way. 1 out of 3 or 2 out of 3, that's how it should be if the percentages play out right. Oh, wait a minute. Who did I get to hit? Oh, I did with this guy. The casualty that regen for you. I got that with the coffer.
Can't make up my mind here. I'm tempted to actually field the ghoul on defense, but it's just too hard to find a spot to put him with this roster. So you like the move, you like your move up on your Tomb Guardians, huh?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I love them.
I don't know if I'd take it that early. I think I'd take it after they had, like, Guard. I don't know if, like, Mighty Blow Guard. I don't know if I'd take it before Mighty Blow. It's just so hard to level them. I guess it would be different. If it was a new team, I could see taking it, but at this TV level where we're at, I don't know if I'd take move because it's just going to be so much harder. Will you just go like the standard build then, or will you go break tackle sooner than normal?
I don't know. It kind of depends on how the rest of the team looks at the time, how I feel.
I gotta think break tackle moves up the list with that guy just cause
potentially, yeah.
Make him really good.
I mean, if I rode doubles next, well, I'm taking block.
No, block for sure.
I was thinking dodge, but if say I rode doubles the next 2 skills and I took block and then dodge, then yeah, break tackle would absolutely be the next skill. But yeah, probably break tackle next. Just depending. If he's taking him forever to skill up, then I might go ahead and take Mighty Blow next and then break tackle.
Interesting. don't know that that really helps me much, but interesting.
Not really going to help you that much. I mean, you could get in my way a little bit, but that's about it. Not really going to help you much in any other way.
And I can limit the three dies initially.
Mm-hmm. You can do that.
Figured you'd defensively pile on there.
Yep.
A little surprised you went after that, because a push puts you into uphill.
Yep. No. Chance I was willing to take.
Thank you.
Him out there on an island for you. Tempting you into taking it.
I know it is, but I can still get back, so yep. It's worth it.
Oh, yeah. But I'd rather you blitzing him than some of my other pieces.
You've gotten your allotment of pals.
Pal right there would have been so freaking nice, dude.
I figured eventually you were due to not get a pal on my Dodgers with the Tomb Guardians.
Shit, I hit
there, you can have it on that guy. You can hit
that
guy.
Wrong fucking guy there. Did not mean to hit him. But... comes in handy. Would have been a lot more harrowing doing that whole play right there if I didn't do that move five right there.
No.
Man, if I'd have made the first one, I might have re-rolled the second one. Can't re-roll it, though.
You can't re-roll that one.
Not when I still need to go for it to score. I may not have used it, even if I failed the second one. I may not have used it, but I would have thought about it a hell of a lot harder, that's for sure. Man. That sucks. Would have been nice to have him standing up in there. At least make you make some dodges.
I'm still gonna have to make one dodge that I don't want to make. I'm just trying to decide how greedy I get before that.
You gonna try to get in there to surf me?
No. Good. That was a two die into an uphill, but I felt I had to take it. Oh, seven on the armor. Well, this is the one I need right here. I need this dodge. And it has dodge, so...
Nah, you're fine. You haven't failed a dodge yet. Not even the first one.
Two die into one die. Well, it doesn't look like I'm going to surf him.
Finally failed to dodge. That's good. Smarter play would have been to go in front. Like you thought about doing.
Maybe. I gotta see what I think you can actually pull off here.
Oh yeah, never mind, you got sidestep on that guy. I forgot that's your sidestep wolf.
Yeah, yep. That makes it a tricky proposition block to hitting him, because it can literally take away your entire avenue.
First things first. Let's do this. If I do that, actually, that can work. I think. I this way. But, unfortunately... No, yeah, I can do it. Man, I'd really love to surf your freaking
yep.
zombie.
I knew I was going to break that skelly, I wouldn't have pushed him up there, but I had to just get him away from the ball carrier in case I didn't get him on my guard.
I could have got a one die to surf him, but I wouldn't have been able to knock that zombie down like I needed to get my skelly in there. My dirty player
yep.
skelly in there.
Yep.
I mean, the chances of me scoring here are pretty slim anyway. I have to blitz, dodge, and then two go for it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Dodge no matter what, even if I get the pow. So, I think I'm going to do this anyway. Oh! Damn
nice.
It, regen.
10-11, nice.
Lucky dog. Oh, and it was a missed next game, too. Damn it. Fucking regen saved you. Ugh, that would have been nice to have him off the pitch for the next half. Four plus. I made a five. Oh, you diving tackled. Uh-huh. I forgot he had diving tackle.
Yeah, I was like, that's a 6+ dodge.
Yep. I almost got it.
Yep.
Totally forgot he had diving tackle.
That's why I positioned it the way I did when you said that I'd have been better putting
him
in front.
I still think you'd have been better putting him in the front because I still would have had to dodge through or blitz him either way. And that's if I got to a point where I could do that. And it would have been a one die blitz.
Yeah, I just wanted the diving tackle on the guy. I don't.
It felt safer getting it on him. Yeah, it definitely wasn't the wrong play.
I knew if I got him on there, plus he was bracketed up top, I was like, the only way you're getting him off is if you blitz him.
Yeah.
And it was going to be really hard to do.
Definitely.
So I knew
the
dodge was
a
six
bad play.
Plus.
I just think, in my opinion, the better play would have been to go in front. But
if I could have got a second guy in front, I would have. But I think you could have just blitzed him diagonal away and then ran in.
Yeah, I'd have taken two go for it.
Yep, it would have just added a go for it, so I was like, I'll just try this.
So, depending on how the dice go here, we could be looking at an overtime game. And unfortunately, I can't get none of your players off the pitch. So.
We can, they just keep coming back, which is weird.
Yeah, that's two big pieces that you've saved regen from. Oh, wait a minute, that's two. Oh, that leveled him, too. The throw rod leveled with that casualty. Nice. Very nice.
God damn it, I wanted my dirty player so I could foul.
You can foul without a dirty player.
Oh, trust me, I will. I wanted him to foul with. That's funny.
Getting lucky. Skating away. Every time. Shame I get fame plus one and can't take advantage of it at all. What was the first kickoff?
You got a reroll. No? What
no,
was
I
it?
Didn't get a reroll.
What the heck was it? I don't remember what it was now.
Yeah, I don't either. Oh, it was, No, that was my last game. Was it a changing weather? No, it was a bride. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we both got a bride. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah.
Yep. Double ones. What did you take with that werewolf skill? Oh, he took tackle. Yeah, he took tackle. Unlife. McLean put a frown face in there.
Yep, as he should.
It'll be okay, McLean. It'll be okay, man. It's been a tough game so far for both of us. I just had a chance to score, but needed a 6 on the dodge, and I got a 5. I've been taking him off the pitch. He's just been getting everybody back. I casualtied one of his golems and I missed next game, and he came back, and then I just missed next game to one of his wolves, and they came back. So he could have potentially been minus a flesh golem and a wolf if he wins this game and played you. But not now.
Honestly, the regen's the only reason I'm even competitive, because you've had probably, what, 6 removals to my 3?
4 KOs and two crosses. Oh, that's fine. You're good, man.
Be a very different game if I fail those regens. I'd be really low on players.
Oh, yeah.
Or on useful players.
Well, and you'd be low, on key players.
I just don't get how you can run a 12-man Khemri team, because you're not taking any losses. You should be down players by now.
Well, I always run it, and I always do good with it. Don't get me wrong, there's times when I have 9 or 10 players to start a game and I have to take some loners, but for the most part I don't. For the most part, I'm pretty good.
I just mean like in the game itself, like I easily could have taken out a few guys on that opening kickoff and you'd have been down guys.
Yep. It's a chance you take when you run a roster like this. That is the chance you take. How do I want to do this? That one didn't, or that one stuck. And then missed next game. He was just doomed to be missed next game, wasn't he? If that's the same one, I don't know if that's the same one or not.
See, this is the type of shit I'm talking about. Like, I cannot get casualties against you, and it should be just as easy for me to do it as it is for you.
Should be easier, really, because I have more armor 7 than you do. You should be actually absolutely getting more than me, for sure. Koffer came to play in this game. That's his second one. That was a big turn. Both flesh golems off.
Same old shit.
Now that begs the question, do I score pretty quick and try to score again before the end of the half? Or do I stall for overtime and see if I can take more guys off? Since you're guaranteed to be minus a flesh golem at least for overtime. I thought you might go that route. Try to kill a...
Well, nothing else to do. I mean, I can't keep anyone on the pitch, so...
Yep. It's tough when you're not able to break my armor like you should be.
Okay. There's really no excuse that I'm not getting anything here.
I understand.
Be willing to bet at this point in the match too, I'm probably, if not ahead of you on blocks, it's very, very even.
Oh yeah, it's got to be close, for sure.
Either way though, even if I manage to win this, you just pretty much sealed my fate against McLean. I can't be down a flesh golem.
He's gonna make it tough for sure.
Not a guard, not a flesh golem like that. There's no way. I agree. I have the same mentality in this game, honestly. I just wanted to stay intact for this game, too. That's why I didn't use the Igor on that. There's no reason to.
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yeah, that's
yeah,
way better.
Yeah, that's much better. Been better off just letting you score so this could end sooner. If I knew I was going to lose three guys on first turn of the second half, I probably would have.
Plot over.
Yeah, he's in a bad spot, though. Worth it to get to KO. And you're probably okay with that too.
Yeah, fine.
He is safe. My regen's working too. Well, 50-50 anyway. Failed the first one. Thank you.
At least we finally punched back a little bit.
This or do I go uphill? Yep, it's a chance I took. Now he's probably gonna die for it. probably going to die for that. It was a risky chance doing that, but I wanted that shot to try to hit him. Couldn't waste the reroll on that one die, though. Wanted to keep the rerolls just in case we do have to go to overtime.
Good bounce for you, though.
Yeah. Not bad.
Well, hello, beautiful.
Topwind, what's up, man? Ah, there's that double failed dodge. First one of the game.
Yeah, I really could use that to not double fail. Take the bad with the good. You've yet to fail a single 1 in 9 block.
Nah, I know, but I could surf you if I get the yellow there. Well, if I get 2 yellows in a row, I have to get the next one as a yellow too. If I get those, then I surf you. But that's the way it goes. Sometimes it's just not meant to be. Jesus. Alright. That one zombie just did not want to go down. Well, I'm gonna take some chances here. Perfect. Because I really don't care if I win, to be honest. I'd rather take the chances of getting you off the pitch. Especially with your stadium needs.
Oh, that's useless. I've had that all season.
It never does me any good either, as you just seen right there. Never does me any good, that's for sure. Well, that was worth taking those risks. At least it got your guard guy off the pitch. Lodging guard as well.
Yeah, that was a pretty ballsy play, because that could have really bit you in the ass.
Oh, yeah. Well, like I said, I mean, I want to win, but I really don't care if I don't win. For me, it's more important to survive, and taking the chance to get your players off the pitch helps me survive. So I am absolutely okay with taking risks like that. Hence why I did the uphill block at the end of on turn 8 to try to surf you as well. Same reason. If it's a draw, it goes to overtime. There won't be a draw. You'll play a full 8 turns in overtime. And then if nobody scores there, it's sudden death. If nobody scores there, then it goes to a kickoff. Well, your regen's been pretty good for you. 3 out of 4, I think. 4 out of 5.
I'll trade. You can regen, and I'll cash like 6 of your guys.
Ah, that was nice, too. That puts him 3 away from leveling.
Just casualty the tackle, Wolf.
No, I'm not hitting him. I'm leaving him alone. Because I want him to have him if he beats me.
The tackle wolf's already off the pitch.
Yeah, he's KO'd.
You have a lot of faith in my 5 guys.
I hear they make decent hamburgers.
Wolf burgers?
Yeah.
Supposed to pile on so I could foul him again.
Oh, I know you wanted to foul him. If I'd have broke his armor, I would have piled on.
I wanted you to pile on too. It was a win-win scenario for me.
Trust me, if I would have broke his armor, he would have gotten piled on. Absolutely.
Hey, there's that 1 and 9. It only took 13 turns.
Nah, I made it pay off.
Is that 7 cash now?
2 that has stuck, and 3 or 4 that have regen, so. Either 5 or 6. Let's see, that was a Minotep.
Plus 6 KOs.
Yeah, the KOs have helped a lot, for sure.
I'm at 2 cash and 2 KOs. Doesn't seem very good.
Surprised you did that, Sam.
I know about the sidestep. Like I said, at this point, I'm not too worried about losing, to be honest. If I do something that screws up and he gets the ball out and wins, then so be it. I want my team safe for next season because I want to bring him from here. So I'm playing riskier and playing a little crazier because of it.
There's like a 0% chance this works.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna try it anyway.
That's what you're supposed to do. If it does work, then you're looking
good.
Can't
tell us, does he? He doesn't have fend, does he?
No, he does not.
No, I clicked blitz, you son of a bitch.
I was just getting ready to say, don't forget to click blitz.
I did. Instead, he stood up.
Well, it wasn't going to work anyway, so.
All I can tell you, McLean, is all your dwarves with dodge are totally fucked because he's rolling pals on every dodge player. That one he has tackle, but early in the game he just pounded on my whites with Toonbird. No tackle.
He would never just pow and casualty me. That's never happened when we've played.
Sooner or later, you guys are both going to understand that it's not just that when I'm doing it every time.
Yeah, okay.
I love giving McLean shit like that. Good stuff, man, good stuff. Turn to 14. Unfortunately, you're going to get two rows at your KO rows. So, you're still going to have a decent shot to do something in overtime. Good thing for me is you don't have any rerolls. Looks like I'm not gonna have any rerolls. There's the pals. Needed that the turn before. Oh, I'll take that. You regen, though. Man, your regen
no defense for 10-12.
Your regen has been spot on.
Like I said, I'll trade you. You can have regen, I'll take the 7 casualties. And the 6 KOs. Oh, 5 KOs. I forgot my dirty player hasn't woken up yet.
Yes, there will be some Diablo after this tackle for just a little bit.
Are we continuing our game, Detox?
I don't know yet. I might have to play. I told one of my buddies that picked up the game that I'm going to give him or play with him for a while.
Oh, whoops. I do not want to pass. I do, however, want to blitz. And it's not going to matter. Still keep me from scoring here. Big hit for you. Well, it was a big hit for you.
Oh, wasn't that a casualty?
Good question. Honestly, just pushes so you have to do go for it, so it'd have been fine. Those guaranteed 2-1 dies. How the fuck do you ever lose a game when you roll this many casualties? Like, it doesn't compute.
When I get elfed or when I get clawed.
Is it called getting spidered when you get casualties a couple times?
It does happen. Yep. I'm half tempted to not score and just let you win.
I think that would be frowned upon by the league.
Just to save my team. I really don't want to have to play next week. I have a strange feeling that McLean's going to kill a Tomb Guardian next week.
And you probably deserve it.
But it's not in my blood to not score. If this wasn't the playoffs and it was regular league and it was like the last game of the season where I couldn't make the playoffs, and it could kill some people in the survivor pool, then I might not have scored right there. That would be hilarious. Yeah, you went 50%. So you're still going to have a chance. I failed mine. You're still going to have a solid chance, dude.
Well, you don't have any speed on the pitch.
Nothing I can do about it. This really sucks. Yeah, the other fucking wolf back too. Well, at least you can get the wolf and the golem. But the possibility it's going to be 11 on 10 to start over. And this is why I almost didn't score, because I figured with two chances you were going to get the majority of them back and it was going to be a moot point. And now I'm going to have to take hits that I didn't want to take. That whole half I was able to control the hits, so I was okay with it. But now... you're going to set it for the one turner instead. Okay. I'll take it. If it means my Tomb Guardian's safe.
Not so sure I can get to where I want to be.
I was going to say, I was surprised you didn't have your sure hands back to get the ball, but you want the extra movement, I take it?
No, I'm switching it up because I don't have a reroll.
Gotcha. I think that's the safer bet, anyway. Siding against the one turn chance.
Yep, just gonna go for the kills.
Damn it.
I think I could have got there, but it was gonna be tough.
With no reroll, it'd have been really tough. But you could have done it. Has it been done before?
It was possible. I just decided I'd rather go for killing shit.
I wish you'd went for the one turn. Where's my perfect defense at?
Damn it.
That is one thing that's went good for you. You've got all the kickoff events your way. Well, except for the very first one. But that still didn't hurt you.
Yeah, but that if I'd have went for it there, I would actually have a really good or a better chance.
You'd only had to push two squares.
It's not the pushes I was worried about. It's the three dodges and two go for it.
Yep. Don't kill my Tomb Guardian. You can kill the Edge guy if you want. I don't care about him. Go, Edge guy, go! Come on, Heskew! Do it, baby, do it! Yeah, we'll take that one. Now I just gotta dodge the damn... foul. Thank you. You needed the third one.
Yep.
Look at that edge, beast. That skeleton is a beast, baby. Ref! Take his bribe! Ref! Oh, fuck, it stuck. And a miss next game. That sucks. Oh, man, do I use the Igor here. It's a coin toss, Talquin. you got your goblin back. Damn it. Why couldn't your other guy came
back? Oh, hopefully that's not the last casualty we see.
Good. Just don't kill nobody. You can score and win. Set this up.
Wishing I'd Igor'd that flesh golem now.
I'm gonna run to the bathroom real quick while you set up.
Alright.
I'm back. Wait a minute, it re-rolled Fan Factor again? Oh, it was the exact same roll as the
same numbers.
One. Yeah, exact same roll. Ooh, I needed my babe again. So that's twice the babe paid off. Hey, what's up, Panda?
Ah, good, you win.
Oh, fuck, I just seen it was a blitz. God damn it. I don't fucking want it.
You don't want a blitz?
I don't want to win.
Who said a blitz is going to let you win?
Because it's not in my nature to not go for the win. But I really don't want to win.
Well, this is high risk, high reward.
I don't really feel like a blitz just gives you a win.
Well, no, but it gives
no,
me...
No, kick was deep enough.
Yeah, and it puts me in a position to be risky and go for it.
Well, I mean, arguably, it puts you in a position to do exactly what you were asking for earlier, hitting him before he hits you.
Well, no, that is true. It does do that. Absolutely right on that. Go for it instead of the dodges, but that's alright, he's safe now, so that's good. I would have failed to go for it anyway with the first roll.
Another one.
risky, huh?
Yeah, what's up, Sup Megs?
It has been a while, hasn't it? How you been, man?
Good.
Hey, that's alright. He's safe. He's safe. I will take it. Thank you.
No reason to foul. Both want just one health change from here.
Yep.
That's reason to foul right there.
I couldn't foul the guy that was standing up.
Good game. Have fun against McLean. I wasn't lying when I said I was just going to score. I just didn't want to get anybody killed. Well, I shouldn't have played as aggressive as I did on the blitz. I should have just did a couple hits and got the hell out. Not let you get so many hits. But I've been fortunate that the hits you've gotten haven't done anything. Good game, sir.
Yeah. Good game.
I am absolutely okay with that. I'll get a miss next game reset before the premiere, so I'll have my two guardian for the first of the premiere. So I am perfectly okay. And I got plenty of SPPs in that game, so.
Ooh, got a good MVP for you.
No, I didn't even look yet. Definitely.
Yeah, I got, I got three removals in overtime?
Yeah, once you got that Tomb Guardian off on turn 16, I decided at that point I wasn't going to go for the win. Because I didn't want to go against the doors with only three Tomb Guardians.
Yeah, I'm not really looking forward to being down a flesh golem either, but.
Yep. Alright, so. Let's go check our guys and see what they're like. And then I can actually update my premiere post that I am going to bring these guys in. I won the game today that I really needed to win, and that was the Champion League's game. I needed to keep the pressure on you. And I did level a two or a throw rod, didn't I? Oh, I got two guys missed next game, so that'd be nice to get both of them back. Fractured leg on the skeleton.
If you were... So in one of my fantasy football leagues, I have Greg Olsen and Jack Doyle.
Ugh.
So I'm like legit looking to trade for a tight end. Would you try to get Tyler Eifert, George Kittle, or Jordan Reed?
Reed.
Kittle.
Reed's more injury prone, but he's also going to get more fantasy value week for week.
Bethard leans on Kittle more than Garoppolo did.
Who leans on Kittle?
Bethard.
Yeah, I've heard that too. I just the guy I'm trying to trade with has all three of those tight ends, so I'm thinking I might try and make a play for one of them.
Personally, and it's just my own favoritism, I like Reed a lot, so I would go after him just because I like him a lot. When he's not injured, he's the best fantasy value, in my opinion. He's going to get you points, and he's going to get you catches and touchdowns. The question is, does he stay healthy the whole season?
Here's my question. What percentage of fab would you spend on Kerryon Johnson and Calvin Ridley if they were available in your league?
No, I don't know.
Ridley, I'd spend a lot.
Kerryon Johnson's available, honestly.
He's available in my 10-man that I'm not in with either of you.
Oh, 10-man, yeah, I could see that.
Ridley, I'd spend a lot. His upside is too good.
Currently, for some reason, we have 200 as our.
All right, I'll be right back.
Our budget on this. And...
All right, so block, kickoff, return, and fend, and he's got a regular skill up. Probably not going to take anything here. Actually, he's my offensive, not my defensive, so he's not on the pitch during defense, so. Hail Mary is not an option on this guy. None of those are. So, since he's offensive.
What about leader?
I already got leader on the other one.
Leader.
Really not a whole lot I do here.
Dallas is decent on them too.
Yeah, on a defensive one for sure.
You don't play with both on the field all the time?
No. No, because I need my skeletons on the line of scrimmage.
I just don't like taking the movement hit.
Nah, I'm not too worried about the movement hit. I position good enough I can handle it normally. There's a steal.
I didn't take any of those.
Yeah, the only thing I'd take here is Hail Mary pass for defense. But he's not in defense normally, so. Wrestle's no good. Shadowing's no good. Strip ball. He's not in on defense. I already got a kick. I guess I could. Well, no, because. Kick's more of a defensive skill. He's not on the pitch for defense. Guess I could go tackle. I mean, it's always good to have tackle. Or pro, but what good would I get out of pro? Because I've already got the re-row for picking the ball up.
Just going to be hitting.
Or potentially dodging. If I'm in a dire situation. Yeah, pros kind of useless.
On offense, I still like Dauntless the best.
Yeah, I mean, Dauntless could come in handy if he had to blitz off a strength 4 piece or something.
since you only have him playing one side of the ball, pretty limited on what skills are good for him.
Yeah.
Oh man, I don't know what to fucking give him.
Maybe you're right with tackle, and then you'll just end up playing him on defense in certain matchups.
Yeah. I mean, you can never go wrong with another tackle, right?
And in certain matchups, you very much need it.
Yeah, oh yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. I got 4 tackle right now, so give me a 5th one. And there's going to be times where I have to play him on defense. Because all I got is 11 players, so... Yeah, we'll go tackle. We'll go with tackle. I was really hoping I'd get lucky and get an edge bump on his next skill up, but... No such luck. I haven't had an edge-boosted throw rod in a long time. Edge boosts on every other piece, but not throw rods. Alright, so we're at 47, 28, 34, and 8, 37, and 108. Ooh, 111. Khufu scored a touchdown, I take it. At some point that I missed. So he should have 5 touchdowns? No, he's only got 3. That's why. I actually had him 111 and he's actually 108, so. Okay, that's right. I had 1 too many touchdowns for him. 57, 52. Ah, that's why I put the touchdown on the wrong place. Touchdown should have went on the throw. There, 57. All fucked up. 2 MVPs. 1 Kaz. Nope, 2 Kazes. Touchdowns, 12. There we go. Did you see I beat Durden? He's no longer undefeated in Empire.
What was that?
Did you see I beat Durden in Empire? He's not undefeated anymore?
Yeah.
Alright. I think I'm good with it. Oh, how much money did I have? I didn't see. 160. Perfect.
Lo, there do I see my father. Lo, there do I see my mother and my sisters and my brothers. Do I see the line of my
people back to the beginning?
No, they do call to me. They bid me take my place among them.
In the halls of Valhalla,
where the brave
they live.